Test. In the heart of Newark, that's where I'm from. Yes, the hood, but by no means the slum. No need to change a thing about me. I'm talking Lisa Durden history. It's just me being Lisa D. It's just me being Lisa D. Y'all, it's just me being Lisa D. You see, my purpose is for me to speak and you to listen. Even if we don't agree, it's my world. Renowned opinion, Lisa Durden's philosophy.
Welcome to the show. As you know, every time I do a show, I do a segment called Styling. Am I styling? You let me know. Now, I think I am styling. I like colors, you know, lots and lots of colors. Now, this is some kind of kimono, some kind of something that's inspired by the Japanese style of clothing. Now, I thought it was nice. I think I got it at Marshall's. I go to Marshall's all the time. It was very cheap. And one day I was watching All of Us, and Lisa Ray had the same shirt on, only in a different color motif. So I know I am styling. Now, it kind of wraps around, you know, kind of cute, loose, satiny. And I like the skirt. Now, the skirt was very cheap. Oh, yeah. Oh, I like that shower. Oh, yes. That's a little different. Yes, I like that. Very nice. I like the skirt. You know, you just mix and match the skirt. I don't know where I got the skirt from. I got it 2 years ago. It's got the green that matches everything else. I've got like a wife beater under here that's coming from, you know, from below the blouse, kind of like layered look. I think I look very cute. Am I styling? You let me know. Yes, I think it's beautiful. Write me. Get on my website, lisadurden.com, and click on email us. Log on to lisadurden.com and click on email us. Now, my hair. Why, people? Why do you keep asking me about my hair in emails? Do you watch my show? Well, I guess I have new viewers, too. New viewers. My hair's locked. Dreadlocks. So I wash my hair, and I take two locks and put them in rods, those little rods, and I put two locks in every rod. I rod them diagonally. Then I go into the dryer while it's wet. Then I get out of the dryer, and I sleep in them. And afterwards, poof, a poodle. Now, I just did it the night before last, so it's a little tight, but as the week goes on, it drops a little bit more. And I do like the earrings I wear. I try to get costume jewelry because I think that if you're not wearing them every day, why spend a lot of money on diamonds? Go to one of your local yokel Macy's and get costume jewelry, or maybe the beauty supply stores, and they look very nice. Diamond earrings, costume jewelry, beautiful. Makeup looks nice. I never talk about my makeup. I get my makeup mixed by prescriptives, custom blended, because it's hard to find makeup for a lighter skin black. You know, Iman, Fashion Fair turns me orange. The darker skin girls have an easier time, so I go to get my makeup custom blend by prescriptives at Macy's. Nice, matches my skin color. Now my boots. I like talking about shoes and boots and things like that because I think shoes make the clothes. Now you big feet girls, like me, if you wear bigger than a size 8, it's hard to find those shoes and boots on sale. You know what I'm saying? You go there and you're like, oh yeah, they have no more left. I have to buy my boots and shoes the minute they fall off the truck because I wear a size 10. If you're wearing an 8 or less, you can wait for the sale. But most of my shoes are, you know, not cheap. They're, you know, $80, $90, $100, something like that. Now, these are nice. They're pointy, and I usually find that pointy boots hurt my feet. But these boots, I will say, I could wear in the streets, not just the bedroom. You know, very nice. And I got these at 9 West. So go to 9 West. And you know what's so funny? I found out that 9 West sometimes has things at 9 West that they don't have at Macy's. And sometimes they have stuff from 9 West at Macy's that 9 West store doesn't have. They make stuff especially for Macy's. That's interesting. So don't look for these at Macy's. You got to go to 9 West store. Lovely. Ah, if, am I styling you? Let me know. Get on lisadurden.com and click on email us. Beautiful. Now, yes, I like to do my segment called shout outs. Now, we know that right now I'm running a show called Lisa's List of Do's and Don'ts. Yes, people, I like to do this once a year, around the new year, so we can get it together and do what we need to do or don't do what we shouldn't be doing. I got an email, and it says, it's from MAK011. Hi, Lisa. I came across your show on cable television on Tuesday night and heard your comments on black men. I'm a black man, and I see the same thing you mentioned about black men rushing to cater to white women while ignoring black women. Yes, I see that a lot. It makes me mad. I agree with you 100%. It annoys me, and he's a man, so you men that call me a man basher, this man says he agrees with me. It annoys him so much that a lot of our black men bend over for the ugliest white women. Now, I never said they were ugly. This is his issue. Okay, fine. While ignoring a black woman, he says, I am of the mind that I won't do that to the black women. If he doesn't help one race woman get on the bus, he's not going to help the other. If he's going to help the white, he's going to help the black. Just want to thank you for pointing this out, as lots of those men just don't seem to realize their stupid behavior, that it looks crazy to other people. They don't realize that behavior looks kind of crazy. I agree. Thank you for writing in. And he signed M. Thank you, M. Now my sponsor. I like a good sponsor. If you want to sponsor my show, log on to lisadurton.com and click on email us. This is one of my sponsors, and she's just dedicated, inspired by the Voce Ethereal Soundscapes. C.V. Haynes invites visual artists, writers, and performers to learn more about music for communication, collaboration, and leadership from C.V. Haynes. So if you want to talk with her, give her a call at 1-866-816-0226. Now, women, listen closely. Men, listen even closer. We're going to be doing a show that talks about things that women can do to you and her to make herself feel good. Have you ever been pleasuring your man and you started to gag? You want to stop that and still pleasure your man and take it all? I have something for you. It's great and it tastes good too. You'll find out what this show is about in a few seconds. Let's talk about it. Every year I do a show called Women and Their Sexuality. I'm back, and we have a lot of stuff to talk about. So kids, some of you tried to sneak and watch the show last year. Parents, tell your children to leave the room. If you're not over the age of 18, don't watch the show. Now for you freaky parents and you don't mind, I question you, but viewer discretion is advised. But if you're 18 and over, this is the show for you. Women and Their Sexuality, let's meet our guests. Well, Madeline, I think I'm going to go to you first, because I did mention a little bit about this stuff we're going to use for giving oral sex to a man, right?
Yes.
Okay, let's start with that right now, since I did mention that at the end. I was going to talk to Rosalind, but you are a pole dance instructor, and what else do you do?
I sell for slumber parties.
Okay.
Distributor.
Okay.
They have a product called Good Head.
Good Head.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, what is that?
All right, it's many things. It is flavored.
Okay.
So if you are giving oral favors, I'll keep it.
Oral favors,
mm-hmm. Then you will come up smelling like you just had freshly brushed teeth.
That's all that. Well, so what does it do?
Well, all right. Then it also will anesthetize the back of your mouth, so that you won't have the gag reflex. There is something in there. Okay.
So that means you can take all of it.
Yes, you can.
Okay. So how do you do that? You just take a teaspoon of it.
You take a dime size amount.
Okay.
And.
Yeah.
And then you put it in your mouth.
Okay.
You could try.
Mm-hmm.
And you swallow. and swallow.
I'll be using this tonight. I wanted her to bring this. I said, make sure you bring this.
Try to put it on your tongue and then try to make it so it... Like,
now, do I chew it?
No, you swallow it, but just, I'll push it, make sure and put your tongue back there and see what happens.
Minty fresh.
Minty fresh.
Now, how long does it take to anesthetize my throat?
Maybe just a couple of minutes, you should be able to feel it.
Oh, okay. Can I keep this for
later
on tonight?
Yes, you may.
Okay. Yes. Ladies, I told you we have something for you. Now, where can we get this? Because women, you know you gag when you're giving favors. Where can I get this?
It is sold by Slumber Parties.
And that's you?
Yes.
Website?
Slumber Parties by Madeline at yahoo.com.
Oh, that's an email. and she does parties, and you can get this. And I know y'all ain't going to tell your friends you saw the show and you're going to order this, but you're going to that party and you're going to say, bring that, Madeline. Oh, I'm feeling it now. Oh,
is it going to?
It feels nice and anesthetized. I can take more in. You want
is it numbing?
It's nice. Yeah, very it numbing. Here you go. Del. Okay, here you go.
I'm not going to use this for the record, okay?
Okay. Oh, lovely.
Just trying.
Women in their sexuality. It tastes delicious.
Mm. It's like toothpaste or something.
Yeah, but not as.
That, this one is yeah. The one flavor. It comes in a sampler pack of different flavors or just a large tube
okay.
of mint.
Nice.
Okay. Well, we'll see.
Rosalind.
Yes.
Rosalind is here. Well, I want to make sure I say the right thing. Rosalind Rogers, you are a human sexuality educator.
Yes.
Now, I know that you do this kind of workshop all the time. I think, what, at Essex County College or Keene?
Keene University. And William Patterson University.
Oh, okay. I thought it was both of those. Okay, mm-hmm. Keene University and Essex County College. Why is it important for us women to talk about sexuality? Men too, but today is about women. Why is it important to talk about sexuality?
It's important because, first of all, women need to be comfortable with their bodies.
Okay.
They need to understand how their bodies work, and they can share that information with their partners.
Okay.
Oftentimes, sex is not something that's discussed. It's just something that's done, and people don't talk about it. One of the keys to enjoying a happy and healthy sex life is to be able to share with your partner things about your body, to know yourself and be able to instruct.
Okay.
We have to be our own owners
okay.
of our bodies.
I agree with that.
Mm-hmm.
All right, now, Del Harris, comedian.
Yes, ma'am.
You are a comedian. Give me a few things you've done lately, because when I first met you, I called you a new jack.
Mm-hmm.
And I know that you have some funny mm-hmm. sex stories to talk about. Because in,
yes.
in your tape we're going to show later on, you talked about living with somebody, and oh my God.
Oh,
and
my
so we'll
God.
See that later on. So what are the things have you been doing in your career?
I've been doing, I just bought a home, so that means a lot of sex.
Oh, okay. Great. With your man.
Yes, obviously.
Excellent. Good sex?
Great sex.
Okay.
Great sex.
Okay.
But I just wanted to, kind of agree with that you do need to talk about it, and that men should not be so offended mm-hmm. by something not working mm-hmm. for you. Like,
That's a lot
of the times mm-hmm. that men mm-hmm. will try to do something mm-hmm. on you that may have worked for maybe 30 mm-hmm. other women or mm-hmm. however many
right.
other women,
mm-hmm.
and that does not necessarily work for you. And I find that it's not hard to communicate right now, but it's been hard in the past mm-hmm. to communicate, like, this worked for me. Mm-hmm. Because they always kind of clam
get
up
all
and
bent out of shape.
Feel like,
and,
yeah, like
it's like mm-hmm. it's personal. Mm-hmm. Oh my God!
And it's not personal. It's just mm-hmm. that I'm trying to, you know, please you in the utmost way, and I welcome
right.
your mm-hmm. comments.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
But you know, please mm-hmm. be that open to me, because you know it's not easy to mm-hmm. tell somebody, okay, this doesn't mm-hmm. really please me here. Mm-hmm. This doesn't rock my boat. You know.
Right.
But whenever you can talk about it, man, is it so much better from there. So
that's what I think.
But anyway, of course, I've been doing like a lot of clubs and all that. But
where can they find you? Is it a website or anything? So that if you they want to go to see you do some comedy.
Yeah, they can see me at exposeme.org. Mm-hmm. www.exposeme.org. Like,
okay.
Give me some exposure.
Mm-hmm.
So, and I have all type, of course, I probably need to, like, update it, but we'll talk about
that. That's
it.
Okay. We'll talk about that later, girl.
Okay.
And Jonah Cottom.
Yes.
I'm so glad to have you. I found her on the internet. Technology is a beautiful thing. Because later on, we're going to have her show us how to dance on the pole. Yes.
Ooh,
you're another pole dance instructor.
Yes.
Talk about that, girl. What do you do specifically? I mean, we'll see more later, but in terms of your business.
Well, pole dancing, it's a great workout, but lately we've been teaching a lot of women for birthday parties and girls' night outs, but our classes, for some reason, have been drawing a lot of women who have had recently had babies, and,
okay.
and a lot of women who have just are growing older and have had hysterectomies and
oh.
just really are just having a turn of events in their lives and just feel like they want to do something to spice things up.
Yeah.
And I really wasn't ready for that in the classes. And I told my husband, I said, you know, I wasn't ready for this, but I love it because I'm getting these tears and hugs at the end of my classes.
Wow.
And it's very rewarding.
Is there a website they can find you at?
Yes, www.exoticdanceworkshops.com.
Now, Rosalind, before we get to the orgasm question, which of course I must do in every show, let's talk about that. That's really interesting that you said women who've had, you know, hysterectomies and babies, you know, what happens to our bodies after those things where maybe sometimes the sex isn't as good or you're not as interested or maybe they feel like there's a body image issue? What's going on with that?
There could be physical changes that take place, certainly. There could be psychological changes that take place. Often as we age, our body parts aren't in the same shape that they were in. We may gain weight.
That's true.
We have babies. There's stretch marks.
Mm-hmm.
Many things happen. If a woman has a hysterectomy, she has to have her uterus removed.
Yes.
And perhaps she may not feel as sexual
sexy.
as she did before. But there are many, many hormones that women can take.
Oh, great.
There's so many different aids and so many different things that are out here that are available. But you have to know to find a clinician that you can work with,
mm-hmm.
and have that doctor prescribe
and
you.
And don't be ashamed to do it, right, ladies?
Right.
Now, speaking of that, let's talk about sex. Now, we got to tell our business in this area.
Mm-hmm.
Orgasms. And you can jump in whenever you feel right. Okay, orgasms. What is it that gives you ladies an orgasm? It's maybe more than one thing, but is it the penis? Honestly.
It is the... Okay, so I was going to...
I mean, the intercourse. Mm-hmm. Intercourse.
The intercourse, okay. But it is the intercourse after severe clit stimulation. Mm-hmm.
So then like, it isn't the penis.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. No. It is like...
Like what? What do you mean?
No. I don't have
clit stimulation.
Okay, it's like when the clitoris is the part of your body that can arouse you to new heights.
Okay.
And it is, you know, it
yes,
is why it
Jonna.
Is, you know, I'm sure every woman can understand mm-hmm. this. Like, if you've ever
yeah.
had
oh,
that
yeah. mm-hmm.
kind of pleasure, then you know that if you, even if you're not going to orgasm from,
the
you know,
course.
Yeah, the clitoris, mm-hmm. But you're almost there. It's like once you have the penis insertion, then it makes it, I mean, your body is just looser mm-hmm. and open, but... You know, you want to get to that point. I mean,
I goal-oriented sex, and
really?
The goal is the orgasm.
That's right.
Right. I mean, when you guys have sex, do you want the orgasm every single time?
Yes.
Do you have it every single time? I mean, you're married. Tell me.
Absolutely.
You do. Well, you dance on the pole, girl. So well, how do you do? Because you know how to get it. Is it intercourse or oral sex? What does it for you?
I think you have to know what you want.
Okay.
And I think it's also very emotional too.
Okay.
I'm obviously not a doctor, but I think that you have to. It's a mental thing mm-hmm. for a female.
Mm-hmm. What do you think?
I think she's right.
Mm-hmm. Really?
I think that your mental state depends a lot on.
On the orgasm?
Yeah. Whether you achieve one.
Okay, let's say that...
achieve a good one.
Oh, there's good and bad ones?
Well, maybe
there's
a little
good
one
and
or
better?
A big one.
Yeah.
There's little and big?
Yeah.
I've only had big ones.
There's a good,
oh, good
Sunday and
look
a...
at you.
Yeah.
I would want a few little ones first.
Yes.
What'd you say?
I said there's a good Sunday and there's a big Sunday. You want the little Sunday or you want the big Sunday?
Yes.
I would like the little ones leading up to the big ones.
Sure.
Okay. Rosalind?
You can have clitoral orgasms or vaginal orgasms. There is a way to say that an orgasm is easier, it's through clitoral stimulation. And depending upon the position that intercourse is taking place, the clitoris may or may not be stimulated during that particular act of intercourse. So you may have oral stimulation or manual
mm-hmm.
stimulation prior to intercourse, during intercourse, or after intercourse. Oftentimes, if a woman is not able to have an orgasm, it may be because she's not being stimulated properly.
That's right, right?
That's right.
For women not to have an orgasm with penetration.
Right, that's what, about 70%, 70, mm-hmm. right? And mm-hmm. you know what, I have these discussions with men. We'll do a men's sexuality show next month, but when I have these discussions with men, like you said earlier, they take it personally. Mm-hmm. It's not, now don't get me wrong, some men are bad in bed. I'm not saying when the sex is bad, because mm-hmm. I've always said, I said, okay, the next time I do a show, I'm going to separate the difference between satisfaction and mm-hmm. good. Mm-hmm. I've had good sex without an orgasm. Mm-hmm. An orgasm is satisfactory sex. Mm-hmm. Good sex means I feel the penis mm-hmm. there, I know you're there, I feel the tingles mm-hmm. in my stomach, but I don't feel a rise going up, mm-hmm. and then boom, there's a difference. Mm-hmm. So what can you say, or we can say that can make the man who's watching with his girlfriend now or his wife, mm-hmm. that can ease his feeling about the fact that it's not him, and you can get past that and just give the woman the orgasm the way she needs mm-hmm. to get it?
Well, I would say, first of all, once again, it goes back to the woman. The okay. woman has a responsibility, first of all, know her body,
okay,
and to find a way to communicate with her partner. Maybe the time for the communication is not during the act.
During the act, oh,
maybe
yeah.
you need to have some discussion prior to
that. Could hurt a person's feeling
getting in bed. And right. there's a way to right. do anything and have any kind of a conversation. And you don't necessarily want to point out the bad things.
Okay.
But you want to talk about how sex could be better for both of you mm-hmm. and the things that you need to incorporate into your lovemaking.
Now, ladies, I think one thing that can help us out to help them, because, you know, the first time I had an orgasm with a man was a surprise. I could not tell him what to do. I didn't know what to tell mm-hmm. him to do. So once he did it, I now knew. But before knowing that, I guess, is it best to start to masturbate? Do you think masturbation is a good way to start to know your body? Y'all know y'all masturbate. Now, come on.
I really...
right?
Yeah.
Especially when come on now.
No, well, I think it is a good way.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, let's be real.
I mean, especially if you haven't had one or you're not sure, there's a lot of different ways that you could masturbate. You know, there's the vibrators.
Let's talk about that. Because, you know, I think masturbation, right, Rosalind, could help out some.
Masturbation is not a problem unless it's a problem emotionally to the person.
Where it's some kind of religious thing.
Sort of
yeah.
guilt, you know, some okay. sort of guilt or something else.
But then watch my show and you should get over it.
For people, men and women, to masturbate.
Okay, so let's see what they can do with some of these things.
Okay.
Madeline. Okay, if you want to masturbate, ladies, this will help you learn your body to help the orgasm come better for those of you who don't know what you're doing. Okay.
There are just some basic toys.
The silver bullet.
All right. The bullet.
The world
all right.
famous.
Oh, the world famous?
The world famous.
I think everybody's heard of the silver bullet.
All right.
Pow, pow. Okay.
Battery operated.
Okay.
Operated. And different speeds.
Now, you can also use it for oral sex. Talk about that.
You can use it when you're having oral sex by putting it
and
on
the side. And doing him a favor.
And doing him an oral favor.
Yes.
By putting it on the side of your mouth, not in your mouth, near your teeth or anything.
Okay, in your cheek, between your cheek
yeah,
and your gum.
Yeah, just like, yeah. No, right here.
Oh, on the outside.
Yeah.
Okay. Wow. Mm-hmm. And then he'll feel the vibration.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, great.
All right, so.
Do you insert that when you're masturbating?
You could use it on your clitoris.
Okay, that's
all right.
Good.
And depending on how soft or how hard, depends on, you know, how fast you, it goes pretty fast. If you
don't
feel this.
That right there.
No, I mean, because it, you know, it goes pretty fast.
Like, what are we doing
with
that?
Yeah, okay.
Okay. So what else do we have?
Okay,
yeah,
so
okay.
That's basic. The, this one over here.
Okay, that looks crazy.
All right, it looks a little scary, maybe.
Yeah,
but
very scary.
It's for G-spot stimulation.
Okay.
And it's curved because your G-spot is on the inner wall towards your belly button of your...
Is that right?
Yeah.
Right, Rosalind?
Right.
Okay, Rosalind knows. All she's right. the expert here.
And so this vibrates. This control has... one controls this part. And the other one controls this for clitoral stimulation.
Oh.
So you can have them both going, or one going, or...
Would you use that? I know you do, because you do the poll. I keep saying you do, because you're married. Does your husband have a problem with these toys?
My husband doesn't care for the toys, actually.
Really?
He doesn't
care.
He doesn't. He has no desire.
Do you use them by yourself?
No.
I don't. I promise I don't.
Okay, well, I was asking.
Personally, out of all these, I think the silver bullet is the most fun, and I had one, but my husband doesn't want to be bothered, so I threw it out.
Well, you didn't want to use it by yourself?
No, I just
see what his feelings would get hurt.
I just attack him if I need anything.
Yeah.
So you're not into the toys?
And now, like, I'm... Obviously, my interests are piqued because I haven't seen, like, the bullet
yeah.
up mm-hmm. close.
Okay.
So I would definitely consider using, like, the bullet. But
yeah.
I really have, I am a person that, like, I like sex with the person. Mm-hmm. Like,
with
I'll just
body.
Hold out. Yes, with
okay.
a human body. And I would just hold out rather than get, like.
See, I'm the kind of person I would do extra. Like, now that is just, I don't want nothing plugged in going in me. So I'm
no,
just
it's not.
It's not
that bad.
I like wireless equipment.
Some girls just like to play with them, just to see what they're going to do. Mm-hmm. Some
okay.
couples like to use them, you know, as couples' toys, or just the husband or the boyfriend may just like to use
and
it.
And let me say, some guys try something new for once. I'm so sick of it. Now, last year I had this lady on the show that gave me a silver bullet, but it was just a small thing like this, about the size of your pinky, and there was a battery inside. Now, I did use it. Anyway, go on.
Yeah.
Yes.
This one is, oops, a vibrator.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
All right. And it has,
turn the light
all right,
off.
Let me turn the light on. It lights up, girls.
Wow. Right. Go ahead. The camera will get it. Right. Oh, wow. That's nice.
So the shaft turns around.
Wow.
It has beads in there. And then there's I'll turn it off so we don't see.
See, that's wireless. That's something I would consider.
Let's
it's wireless.
The texture of that, because that looks like.
Is it soft? Is it like pliable?
Yeah, and the
is
other
it
one.
Pliable?
Yeah, let me just.
Or she could just pass it on to her.
You pass it open. You could
yeah,
open it.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. Just open it.
Well, I just want to.
Let me see.
Like,
yeah, it's
like,
soft.
No, it's like Jell-O.
Yeah,
it's like Jell-O.
Most of them yeah. are like jelly. Some of them are harder. Some of the vibrators have bigger girth, depending if you want
okay.
something,
mm-hmm.
you know, something wider.
Yeah.
And then the other one will. Right. The other control is for
the clitoris.
The clitoris.
Okay. And what are these other two things you have there?
All right.
Let's go through those really quickly.
All right. This one is a flavored lubricant.
Okay. And
all
what
right.
are you lubing up?
You could use it for yourself with a vibrator.
Oh. Okay.
I mean, if you need mm-hmm. lubrication,
mm-hmm.
and a lot of women
us older
need lubrication.
Females may.
Yeah, I mean, some
that's
females
my issue,
won't.
But, you know, over 40, they say you kind of
yeah, sometimes
might need.
You'll need extra lubrication.
Okay.
So this one's flavored, and the company also makes one that doesn't have any flavors or any odors, or so for a person who just doesn't want
okay.
anything like that. Mm-hmm. And this one could be used as a lubricant,
okay.
but it could be used for giving sexual favors. It heats up.
Oh, wait, no, if you're giving sexual favors to your man, now, how would that work?
You
put it in your mouth?
Well, you could also rub it on him.
Oh, and it heats up?
It heats up.
Can I keep that one and this one?
You're good, yes.
Okay, I'm good. I'll be a good girl. Okay, oh, that's great.
Yeah.
So it adds extra sensation for him?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Excellent.
And for you also, if you have penetration, so.
Oh, so you can heat up too?
Yeah, you can heat up
too. I'm liking that.
And it comes in flavors.
Okay. Now, does penis size count?
Absolutely.
Do you mean big or small?
I mean,
is the size big or small that you're going for, Dell?
Just small.
Be damned.
Up with their heads.
Once again, though, from a physiological standpoint.
Oh, who cares? Go ahead.
Only
No, go ahead, Rosalind.
First third of a woman's vagina has the most sensitivity to it, okay?
The first third of a woman's vagina.
So you didn't know
vagina,
you learned.
Okay?
I agree.
So, in that case, the depth would not, or the length would not be as much of an issue, but psychologically.
Yes,
like some
it's a
men
good visual.
Prefer larger breasts, or some men
That's
prefer
correct.
Whatever they prefer. Some women are turned on by a large penis size. It does not mean that a man with a smaller penis is not capable of providing satisfaction.
Small penis guys, don't worry.
Yeah, really.
She won't call you, but they will.
Okay. Yes, and you welcome
no,
to
they
them.
Won't.
Too.
No, she won't. She's married.
Well, even if I
Oh, you like a big penis too, Joe? That means Dave's penis is big. You told his business.
No, I love my husband.
The whole neighborhood's going to know about Dave.
He's not a cheater, so I don't care.
That's good. So why do you like the big penis? A larger penis?
I don't know. I guess it's just, it's not pitiful and pathetic. And just, it's not to be mean or hurtful. I wouldn't want to hurt anyone's feelings.
John.
It's just you. I guess it just goes back to
just
probably am red. Aren't you glad you're black?
I love black people.
Everything's so light as a thing.
That's hilarious.
But it goes back to like 100,000 years ago. We want someone big and strong. You don't want like a little boy in bed. You want a strong man.
But that's psychological.
My husband to be is like really large, mm-hmm. and like for me to have orgasms sometimes, like for him to touch mm-hmm. my G-spot, he does have to like
pull out mm-hmm. some.
Come then, mm-hmm. Or orgasm mm-hmm. then, like once it goes down a little mm-hmm. bit, then I can orgasm completely, mm-hmm. like because it's smaller, because it's like.
Well, I like, mm-hmm. you know, people but have said, men have said that we're not visual. That's such a lie. I'm visual. I don't really need the big penis for mm-hmm. the sensation. I like when the man is naked and he just comes in the room and it's just big. Mm-hmm. I'm just looking him up mm-hmm. and down. Mm-hmm. Baby, I got my little mm-hmm. gel to make my, what is it going to do? Anesthetize my throat and pleasure you. I just like a big penis. Anyway. We did a segment earlier today to talk about the sensuality of dancing on the pole. We have these ladies that are going to show us what we're doing. Who knows how it's going to turn out? Take a look. Mm-hmm. So let's hit some music so we can get started.
Absolutely.
All right.
So some little hip rolls.
Okay.
Some squats. Work your quads.
Now, what are these moves that you're doing? What are they called?
Well, this one is just a basic hip roll. This one is a fireman.
Okay.
Just raise your leg up.
Okay.
Arch.
Now, apparently, you've been doing this for a long time.
It does take a little bit of practice, but it is amazing with just a little bit of practice. What the basic 1 hour workout, you can walk out of the gym and go home and incorporate into just working out in your bedroom, even without a pole.
Okay.
You can take your wall or your bedpost and just slide down.
What, you think you can do that?
You know, I'm gonna try. I don't know.
A nice way to get up.
Okay.
Is just simply rock over, put your knees together, and push up. Pop your hips side to side. Anybody can do that. It's all about the eye contact.
Okay.
Feeling in touch with your body, Lisa.
Now, what's the touching your body thing doing?
Just knowing the parts of your body is moving behind the wave of the music.
Okay.
And feeling comfortable with your body. A lot of people touch their body and they feel uncomfortable. It's your body. Love it. Enjoy it.
Okay.
You don't have a pole, and a lot of women don't. A lot of people don't have a space for a pole. Even though you see the stage, you don't have to have a big stage. You can just, but you do need the space around it, especially in the city in New York.
Mm-hmm.
You know, a small apartment with a bed is quite expensive. And to have space for a pole and dancing around it can be quite pricey.
Whoa!
So, that's a fine one.
Okay.
Very easy. All you have to do is just stretch your muscles.
Okay.
And feel comfortable in the air with your legs out like that.
I feel comfortable with my legs in the air. What about you? No, we're gonna bring
Madeline up.
Madeline up. Another, you know, you're gonna tell us what she's doing.
I'd like to show you a different perspective on pole dancing.
Okay.
Different technique.
Yeah.
A lot of the same moves. It's just a different form of it. Madeline loves to climb the pole. Go ahead, Madeline.
Okay.
I like that.
She also loves to do the turns on the pole, the fireman. She loves to do all the same things that I like to do, but it looks so different with another young lady.
Okay.
So what you might see one person doing on the pole might
keep
look...
Keep doing things, Madeline, as she talks. Keep just making your move. We're not...
Try the fireman.
Okay.
Might look so different that you might not even recognize that move with another young lady.
Oh.
Unless someone points it out that that's exactly what she's doing.
Okay.
So, do a back arch. So just do whatever you want to do. Whatever makes you feel
comfortable. Just do whatever you want to do. And now, how is this helping our sexuality? What is this doing when you're on that pole? How is it making you feel sexual?
I think...
It looks like hard work to me.
At first, it can be quite a workout, but once you get a routine down, or at least the basic moves to incorporate into each other, it's not so much a workout because it's so much fun and it's sexy. And want to do some pool work? As much as you can on this smaller stage. And that's the nice thing about the smaller stage here. You can work with a small area, but if you don't have a pole, you can do so much on the floor.
Okay,
and in our workshops, we really work on that because women don't want to invest in a pole.
So we have about a minute left, and we're going to try to do some stuff. That's okay. What can we show? This is Del. She's another guest on our sexuality show. Come on up,
please, Del.
Let's see what she can do. Something really quick.
Okay, Del, if you'd like to come up, if you want to show her the walk around the pole, hold your hand nice and tall, and walk around the pole as if you're a nice, sexy, lean, feline creature. Yes. And you walk and just show off all that you have.
Okay.
Get out of your way. Show off every bit. Yes, show those hips off. Be proud of all that you have. Yes.
Oh, Lord, I'm kind of big. I'm tall. Okay.
So you have the upper hand on us that you're so tall. You're lucky.
Okay. We have to do our mics this way. Okay. Now, I'm kind of a tall person, so the pole is almost my height. So what do I do?
Well, normally you're not going to be on this kind of pole, but you're just going to walk around, hold your hand up nice and tall.
Okay.
And just walk around.
Touch myself.
And tuck your
you can
come
doing?
Around and come underneath your arm.
Oh.
Underneath and tuck back and under.
Okay.
Very pretty. Yep.
Okay.
And you can turn around. You can even do the fireman spin.
Oh, the fireman spin?
If you want to do that.
Okay.
Walk back around the pole. So you're untangled.
Okay. I'm tangled. Okay.
So.
Let me untangle.
So it's
okay.
The fireman.
Well, it doesn't matter. Let me just do it with the tangling. It doesn't really matter. Okay.
Probably people's most favorite spin of all is the fireman.
Okay, fireman spin. Let's try to spin. Fireman spin. What am I doing?
Okay, you're gonna go around the pole.
Okay, around the pole.
And you're gonna put one foot up like this.
Okay.
Around like this.
Uh-huh.
You get to have your
foot. Okay.
Let me have your leg, honey.
Okay.
This part of your leg is going to be here.
Uh-huh.
And the outside leg is going to kick out around to create your momentum.
That's a cute way you got up.
Apparently, I don't have a pole in my house. But you know, ladies, you know, if you don't have a pole in your house, they can still do certain things on the floor, right? Or on the bed. Right?
Absolutely, and there's so much you can do on the floor, and even on a little table if you have a wooden table, and you know, definitely not on a glass table.
Right.
You could even heat up some lotion in the microwave.
Make
sure, yeah, and do a little lotion show or do something fun as a nice little Valentine's Day present or a birthday present or a halftime show.
Okay.
We get calls all the time of past students saying, you know, what can I do? I want to do something special. I need a little refresher course. Can you email me something? So I'll just email over, okay, heat up some of this or pick up some paint and some body paint, mix it with some lotion, get a black light, and do it on the kitchen floor. And you know, you can do so many fun things. Wow them. You don't have to go spend a lot of money on a pole and make a big deal out of it.
Are you going to do some of this stuff now?
Well, you know what?
Del, since you're getting married soon.
It's funny you're mentioning that. You know, I just saw a special on splashing. Have you ever heard of that?
No, what's splashing?
Okay, well, look, there's a magazine. It's called Splash, and I watched it on television, and where the people, they got, like, all these cakes and pies and lotions and pudding and all that, and they mixed it all up, and, like, the woman, like, had would sit in the pie, and then, so, you know, they're naked, or they have maybe underwear or the barest minimum on, and they would, you know, get together. Now, of course, when I saw it on television, it was with many people, but I wouldn't have bought the stuff because, you know, with my partner, that's different fun in the house.
Absolutely.
So I bought, like, some whipped cream and a pie, and I got some pudding, and we haven't done it yet, but we're definitely going to, like, because we haven't an event coming up, you know.
You know, some of these erotic things, you know, we don't think about doing, like, that's something that's just totally different and out of the box. You know, I think that that brings a spice into a relationship, especially if you've been married for a long time or living with somebody or dating someone for a while, right? I mean, why are women so funny about, like, you know, being tied up or doing splashing? Why do you think there's an issue there? It's big in the United States. Like, we're very funny about sex here. In the UK and Europe, they're very open.
The United States has a really puritanical view about sexuality, especially about women's roles. Women are supposedly good girls or bad girls.
Okay.
And good girls just don't.
Don't do that.
They don't do that.
They don't
get
choked.
Sex is for procreation.
Right.
Or sex is for making love with your husband or the person that you love. But we don't really teach our girls about enjoying sex. Their sexuality and owning their sexuality, and I think that is
another thing.
Factor.
I think in relation to that, in the puritanical situation, I saw this on Oprah, so we can certainly do it here on the Lisa Durden Show. If you have a comment, go onto my website, log on to lisadurden.com, click on email us. Porn or what they call sex videos or erotic videos. You know, I hear women say, "Oh no," but I know that they're watching them, right?
It's very helpful.
Tell me about that.
It is.
And we know that it's the truth.
It's nothing, it is.
We go, ew, but really? Right?
Really, it is true.
How does it help you?
It gets me in the mood more.
And you know, for women who kind of like, they need to get over that, you know?
Right.
And I think that they started to make more erotic videos that have a little bit more plot, a little bit more affection in it, but they're out there. And I think that they do help a lot in your sex life. And so instead of making the man embarrassed because he wants to pull out a tape or he's hiding them in the drawer, because I've seen guys, I'm like, what's that, it's a tape? Take it out. And I say take it out, they still feel ashamed because they've been so used to men saying, no, you know, right? And you're married, so I know that you have to add all kinds of stuff to spice up your sex life.
Well, because the children and the babies, it's like, babies are crying all night or coming in the bed at all hours of the night.
Right.
It's hard.
Right.
It's hard. You have to make a date.
Now, how can we, Rosalind, you know, because we all agree, right? You introduce erotic videos into your relationship, right?
Yeah. Yeah. And I even suggested, like,
me too.
Which ones to get because, like, I don't like to see the hardcore. No plot, no nothing.
Right.
Like, I like to see
in a funky apartment somewhere in the hood, and you got
sores
on your ass.
That's the truth. Yes,
you got your junkie. I mean,
yes, and I like, you know, I like it to
something
be
nice.
Very sensual.
Yes,
I don't mind the woman to woman videos also.
Really?
Because that is turning my partner on.
Oh.
It's definitely turning me on. If a woman is suppressing the fact that it's not turning her on,
she's
a lie. Because
y'all are all lying. Y'all are all lying.
Y'all are all lying.
Right, Rosalind?
So,
to each his own.
It doesn't necessarily mean that I am you know, trying to push it on someone. I'm certainly, like, not carrying over what is fantasy into real life.
So you wouldn't introduce another female into your sex life with your partner?
No, because this is my home and it's sacred, and I, you know, going forward, looking into the future.
Okay, let's say it wasn't your home. Let's say you weren't engaged and it was just some man you were with. Has anybody here had a menage a trois?
Absolutely not.
Okay.
No, I haven't.
Mm-hmm.
It's been suggested to me, but I haven't.
Well, we've all.
I was getting ready to say.
Everybody has had a man that's asked. It's just no.
They all ask.
Have you ever go, I wonder how that would be? Have you ever thought about it? Like, curiosity, but just kind of didn't do it?
I mean, you definitely think about it. Like, you definitely think.
I figured that about.
Everybody wonders what it would be like. Women are certainly very beautiful, and you cannot, if you're not acknowledging that portion of a woman, then you probably don't love your own body, because your own body is very, you know, that's what we talked about with the pole dancing. It's like you have to love your own body. So certainly when you see somebody else's, that definitely could be arousing, but I prefer not to take it any further.
Because, yeah, you know, talking about fantasies, some fantasies should just stay fantasies. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Do you agree?
Yeah.
Like, every fantasy you could ever have shouldn't be acted out in your sex life, you know. How about a little choking? Sexual asphyxiation? Mm-hmm. But not to the point where you're not breathing. You ever been choked?
No.
That's nice.
To each his own.
It happened. I didn't ask for it, but you know. Mm-hmm. And I was like, oh. So the first, this fool choking me. Okay. And you know, you don't want to mess up the, you know, the erection by saying, hold it, fool, you're choking me. And you know, so I said, let me go with this and see if I'm going to go out of breath right here. So I didn't go out of breath. I was like, ooh, I got out of that one. But then he kept doing it after that. And then I was like, oh, amen. I never requested it. No. It was nice. It was a little, not like, he didn't just start choking.
Was it like the pressure? Or
the pressure. Like when the man is, you know, on top and he's holding you down from your neck versus your shoulders. Mm-hmm. So it was a choking in that sense. Mm-hmm. That wasn't bad.
But like, how?
You got to try that.
Like,
no, it wasn't. No, it wasn't necessarily stimulating. It was just something different to do. Mm-hmm. You know, everything I do is not necessarily going to stimulate me sexually.
And control.
I like being controlled sexually. Right?
Lisa, statistically, about 1,000 people in the United States die that way every year. So be careful.
I've only done it like 3 or 4 times.
Okay. We don't want to read about your girlfriend.
I never asked for it.
Okay. Like, she went back for more.
Sexual asphyxiation. Don't do it, kids. You shouldn't be watching. If you're not 18, turn the channel right now. I mean it. Anyway. Okay. Well, I'm not advocating it, but it did happen.
No, so it's just something that is done.
Have you ever been in a sex act where something happened to you? What the hell? You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. Right.
Where you didn't like something and then you started to like it, like being cursed out and called bitch in the bed. Mm-hmm. Where that was just something that happened to me. I was like, oh my God, this person's up. Then I ended up saying, okay, it's not bad. Has it ever happened where something happened to you sexually that you weren't for in the beginning, and then at some point you were like, they kept doing it, and you were like, oh, it ain't bad. Mm-hmm. Nothing?
I hope it's an opportunity for communication and discussion later.
That's another thing I wanted to say.
We didn't talk about it later.
You had mentioned not saying anything during sex, but I find communicating during sex is the best, because... Mm-hmm.
But as a motivator, not like to correct.
Yeah, like as a touch
don't
me here,
stop it,
do
don't,
this
you know,
there, do this
yeah,
there.
Baby, like, you know, yeah, talking.
Move down, move up, do left, side.
Right.
And I also ask them to communicate with me. How would you like to hear? Like, sometimes, you know... my husband, for instance, my husband-to-be, he likes the middle of his...
Armlets.
Whatever this is. And I wouldn't know that if he was to say, move up, hot, warm,
cold. Like,
And we discovered
that.
Well, you certainly can communicate and talk during sex, but I was just saying that should not be the only time.
Right, yeah, because you might end up in a situation where it's a scary, you know, you needed to tell us that you like choking people first, and, you know, over dinner or something. Right. You know what I'm saying? Okay, anal sex. No. People are doing it. Okay. Mm-hmm. Let's talk about anal sex. Mm-hmm. Do you like it?
I love anal stimulation, but because, you know, it's so large, I'm afraid of, you know, it going in there. But I love to be stimulated.
So you like a finger or something?
Yes. like,
you know, a little sliding,
I mean, it's
through.
The most sensual area, I think.
Okay, so like, you like the anal area. Is your anal area sensual?
Very, but I'm afraid. I'm afraid of danger zone.
You're afraid, but you're curious though, because your anus is very sensual.
Yes, but no, I don't want anything inside there.
Not even a finger?
No.
You pole dancers are boring.
I'm sorry.
We have our poles.
No, how about you? Is your anal area sensual?
It is, but okay. I'm just sort of afraid of it, just as because of cleanliness and
right.
that type of thing.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Rosalind.
And because the anus is just has a very...
very delicate,
delicate
tissue.
Yeah. And you could really do, could do a lot of damage.
So, Rosalind, so we know that people are doing it. Mm-hmm. So let's just talk about the anal
That's
sex
so important.
Thing.
First of all, you should never go from the anus into the vagina.
Okay.
With penis, finger, toy, sex
nothing.
Toy is nothing because you're carrying bacteria from one area of the body into another area of the body, and that's going to cause a lot of problems. The secondly, and you just mentioned that, the tissue in the anus area is very, very sensitive, and that tissue is subject to tearing.
Okay.
So you need to be very, very
so
careful.
So do you all
it
like
is a
little,
high risk activity too?
Do you all like a little salad tossing?
Who wouldn't?
Tossing a salad means that you are getting stimulation in your anal area with the person's tongue. Yes.
Once again, another high-risk activity, and there are certainly ways to do anything.
Okay. Make sure everything's clean. You don't go from the tongue back to other parts of your body.
Right.
Well, anyway, is this the end of the show already?
Oh.
But we're going to do Dell. We're going to do Dell's video because we're going to show that Dell is very funny. We want to kind of go out.
Mm-hmm.
One quick thing that you could leave with people for this sexuality show, one good thing they can do to boost their sex, like one thing.
I would say visit Planned Parenthood in Essex County or Passaic County, mention the Lisa Durton Show, and you'll get a $25 discount off of your visit.
Yes, one quick thing.
Enhance the romance, try different products, sex toys, lubricants. Oh, yeah. You're bringing that home, honey, right?
Dell?
Laugh and talk a lot with your partner. Laugh and talk a lot.
Okay.
Love your body. Use your body with your partner. And visit us at www.exoticdanceworkshops.com. And you can enjoy any of our classes at half off.
Anything that's not missionary sex, I advise you talk about over dinner. Don't start choking, folks, you know. Anyway, let's see. Let's check out Dell. Goodbye. Dell's going to do some comedy for us. And we're just going to laugh at everything. Thank you, ladies, for coming.
is all over the tri-state area. Layla Dell is in the house. Come on up.
I take you home with me tonight, but you look a lot like my man. I don't know how that's gonna work out. You know, before I even get started, let me count to three and let y'all give me a big practice laugh. I wanna make sure you can do it, goddammit. One, two, three. Was that a scream or a laugh? Let's try that again, okay? Give me your heartiest ha-ha-ha, back slap and knees. One, two, three. Oh, sounds so good, darn it. Where's Brooklyn at? Some of you, the rest of y'all familiar with Brooklyn? Because I'm just moving to New York. And, you know, I guess I didn't realize how close Brooklyn is to Kingston, Jamaica. Either that or it must be some type of free direct flight a day from Jamaica to Brooklyn. Because, goddammit, Jamaicans are everywhere there. And I love Jamaican people. Don't get me wrong. They've got good food. They are friendly. Do I got any Jamaicans up in here?
Irish.
Just two? Okay, we can jump this bitch if she get out of hand. Love my Jamaican people, but I can't understand shit they're talking about. And they always trying to give you advice using these no-nonsense cliches. Have you spoken with a Jamaican lately? I'm talking to my new Jamaican homegirl. I'm like, what should I do about my boyfriend? Should I call him? Should I not? She was like, me go tell you one thing straight, girl. If a man have two birds and one stone and a fling the stone, doesn't it mean the other bird them will fly away? I was like, huh? Do I call this guy or what, girl? I can't understand that bullshit. And what is that stuff you smoking on? She said, here, mommy, took this. I said, So let me get this right, girl. You said one bird or two birds? Red fish, blue fish. And I see why people are always selling me something in Brooklyn, because y'all, have you been to Jamaica? Oh my God, they are, everybody is selling something over there. Have you been? Girl, I walked by the water in Jamaica, even the fish was like, Amon, oxygen, $2. Breathe forever. I'm feeling good tonight, honey. I am officially a homeowner. Round of applause for that. Yes, indeed, honey. Officially a homeowner. Now I'm looking out my window calling the police. Police is like, description, ma'am? I'm like, yes, white male, 6'1", dressed in a three-piece business suit, carrying a briefcase. Now, he looks like he could be going to work, but I know the buses pass much more frequently than that. Send someone right away. I'm in here alone. Been checking my investments, too. You know what? Let me school y'all on something. Did y'all know that the first commodity on Wall Street was the slave? Did y'all know that? Yes, indeed. Now Wall Street is returned full circle. You can now invest in prisons. Prisons are public stock. Did you know that? Yes, honey, they are locking our black and brown brothers up and turning them into stock. Now, it hurts me to say this, but I had to invest. That stock is promising, honey. It's always going to be some stupid motherfuckers committing crime. Oh, yes, indeed, child. And you know what? The brothers must not know it either. The brothers must not know they have the potential to be stocked because I still see them standing on the corner, child. And now I ride by like an old white man yelling out the window, boy, you better get off that corner, boy, make me some money off you. Yes, child, the brothers in the big house gonna buy my next house. Said I wasn't gonna be doing too much cursing because you know what? All week people been like, Del, you are so funny and so cute, but you've got to stop cursing. And you know, my first reaction was, I am pretty cute. And then I thought about it, like, why do I do so much cursing? You know, my mother does.